As a reviewer, I use things like the HBN Power Meter to help me a lot in my testing, like I did with the AMD Radeon RX 9070 XT, the benchmarking, and to test the average and the total power consumption in the system. In this video, we're going to do an unboxing, and then I'm going to show you several different uses, and then also how to use the HBN Power Meter. So let's start with an unboxing, and then move on to the product usage. All right, so here we are again, the plug-in power energy meter from our friends at HBN. Energy savings, features and information display, product description, and UPC along the top. Let's go ahead, open it up. So we have here the instruction manual, and we're gonna go over a lot of what this is gonna have in it. So don't worry too much about this, at least for now. And then that's it. We have the unit itself. It is nice and sleek looking, very shiny. All right, we can see the outlet here and then the other outlet here that you'd plug your devices into. So this is going to come in handy to utilize to see how much wattage something is taking, then over time to see how much that device is costing you. When I started reviewing, I was using a device just like this to calculate all the wattage being taken up by machines. And that's how I did my initial review. So these things help a lot, not just for my reviews, but to save you potentially a lot of money and seeing where your money's going. So let's go check out my PC real quick and let's see how this works. So I have a surge protector right next to my PC. We're gonna plug in this unit. We're gonna turn it on real quick and then we're going to set the kilowatt hours so that we can see how much my PC has cost me over the hour, over the year, over the everything. So now what we're going to do, in order to set this correctly, you're going to look at your bill. And for example, if your bill is $120 and you've used 1,000 kilowatt hours, you're going to divide 120 by 1,000. So for me, I've used 1,717 kilowatt hours and my bill is $157.96. So 157.96 divided by 1717. So my cost for kilowatt hours is 9 cents. So what I'm going to do here, we're gonna press and hold set. And then we're gonna calculate it here by the plus or minus. And we'll set here 0.90. And then we'll hit set again till it's set. All right, so we're at 0.90. So 1 second, I'm gonna go ahead and shut down my PC and then plug it in here and we'll see what this says. 1 sec. All right, so now we're going to plug in my PC right over here. Just move everything out of the way. And we'll switch to watts. So now everything's off. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. Okay, and the display goes to sleep after a few seconds. So to wake it up, we just tap the button. So right now, just booting up, we're almost at 300 watts. All right, for a split second, we hit 301 watts. So as you're using it, of course, you know, it's gonna be going up and down. And that's just booting up the PC and then getting into a stable state in Windows. So in a second, I'll show you what the idle state is. So 1 sec, I'll be right back. While that's running, we'll go ahead and run through some of this over here. So here we can calculate the cost. So far, there is no cost associated since we've barely been using this right now. Then over here, we can see the wattage consumed, the voltage consumed, back to wattage, voltage and wattage over here, the kilowatt hours used, so not even an hour yet. Elapsed time, 6 minutes, kilowatt hours, and then here we have Hertz and power frequency. Here we have voltage, and then where we can set, and then amperage, and where we can reduce the value, and on voltage, we can increase the value, as you saw me put in the rate for my electricity cost. So while I'm waiting for my PC to become idle so that everything drops down, I wanted to show you my PC. I'll have the specs and everything down below, but the reason I'm showing this to you is I have a 1000 watt power supply in that computer. As you saw when the computer posted, I was barely using 200 watts. As I was using more of it, booting into Windows and everything, it went up a little slightly higher than 300 watts. When I'm gonna play games, or when I'm exporting video or editing video, or when I'm doing something incredibly CPU power hungry, power consumption goes up. I still may never hit 1000 watts, but it's good to know that it's there. But I wanted to show you that just because I have 1000 watts doesn't mean I'm going to use 1000 watts. So that'll definitely help you in your build as well. My PC would typically idle a little lower, but because I do have a screen recording program running, it's at about 200 watts. So I'm starting up the screen recording program. You saw the wattage go up. Now I'm going to do a quick benchmark.
As soon as we find a good spot, we can get things set up and ready to go. And then we can get started.
So starting off the benchmark, we'll see this start climbing. You can see, let me throw some light on that. You can see now we're 400 watts. We hit 500 watts a second ago, and or a few seconds ago. And now as the benchmark starts up and people start doing their thing, you're going to see it even go higher than that. Now that's just PCs because that's what I use it for. But you can use that for maybe toasters, for coffee makers, for hair dryers, hair curlers, just about anything that connects into a wall. As long as it's not over 1,875 watts, you're completely fine. Anything below that, you're fine. Anything above that, you won't be able to use that. But so far, I think it's pretty awesome and I'm gonna start using it as well just so that I can check out everything around my house. So coming back to this, it's been running for about an hour and 56 minutes, anywhere between 100 and 600 watts, typically on the lower side. We can see down over here, the kilowatt hours. Coming over here to cost, we can see that that time that I've been using it, we've only used about 4 cents. So it's only costed about 4 cents during that time, which is great. But mind you, that's only 2 hours of one device running, again, anywhere between 100 and 600 watts. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou showing you the HBN Watt Meter. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.